There are six different materials.
So six columns and two rows.
Okay.
So the two rows are gonna be the rubber stopper in the middle, and then the columns will be each of the surfaces.
Kind of like this?
Yeah, and then you'll record the degree in the boxes that intersect.
Okay. So the material goes across, kind of like that. So one of the things that's there, actually, okay, so I labeled them, in case you don't know what they are. One of them is felt. And then you would just, do you guys agree with this? Does this look like a good idea?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah? And what are you measuring?
Degrees.
Degrees of?
The angle of the table to the paper.
Okay, or the surface?
Do you do it as like an obtuse angle or acute angle? Like, do you measure the inside one?
Do you measure the inside angle or the outside angle?
Inside,
yeah. So what's the independent variable here then? What's the independent variable? Tell the person next to you, what's the independent variable? And what's
and the material.
The material.
The material is the friction. That affects the angle that it has to be.
So what are our possibilities? So you have friction, material. What are some other possibilities? Did anybody get the washers?
Yeah. Stopper.
Or the stopper? Yeah. Anything else that might be independent variable? What do you think, Mitchell?
Height?
The height?
Yeah.
The height is the same there.
The angle?
You mean the angle? Okay.
Wait, isn't the angle the dependent?
No.
How do you know what the dependent variable is in any of those situations? Okay. Changes because of the independent variable. So when you measure, what are you measuring here? The angle. What's changing because of the angle? Good job. Say to yourself in your head,
what's changing because of the angle, or what is?
What changes the angle?
I'm
going to say that backwards.
Oh.
And before Mitchell says anything, in your head to yourself, what do you think affects the angle? You guys have something in your head? What do you think, Mitchell?
The materials and the washer and stuff.
Materials and washers. That's two, though, huh? That's kind of weird. Can you have more than one?
Yeah, I think so.
Sophia.
I would just say the friction, because the friction combines both the materials and the washer. Takes a consideration.
materials, and because there's not, there are not 18 samples of each material. So just take one or two, take it to your table, and then take them out. And when you're done testing, you'll put them back at table 5.
You gotta know how to use this stuff, bro. Alright, give them the stopper. Give us the washer.
This is my
fine. Get more than. That's 20 degrees on the dot. Do you guys just want to use this one since it's already done?
Oh, yeah. And then you guys can use it.
No, keep the things on it. Keep the things on it, Mitchell.
What? No.
Yes, because they're going to use it, and we're just going to switch this up. That way we don't have to go through and take it apart and then put it back together.
Wait, does it have to move all the way down?
Yeah.
I don't think.
Okay. Wait, what?
I just have even more questions.
Wait a second.
Is it good?
Here, you hold this. You're supposed to put that. No.
You're supposed to put
Yeah, the middle of the protractor is supposed to be at the corner of the whiteboard, flat.
Not me.
Because then the whiteboard, wherever it is.
Like you
say,
that's your form,
and it's still okay. Yeah. Does it have to go all the way down, or is it like just
oh,
it's still yeah? So it's just
I mean,
when it starts.
Okay. Wait,
so
did that actually like go all the way down?
It was just sticky, so when
something.
It starts to move,
it was sticking.
That was actually fun.
Yeah, Trevor, we.
Yeah, you guys are right.
Okay,
Alright, next is the construction.
I'm gonna have your attention for just a second. If you guys share your data with each other, you'll have a bigger data set.
Alright, you ready, Mitchell?
Should we only do 10? Yeah, because you have to measure on the inside.
Oh, okay.
Where the pressure's at?
Okay, now we have to do the washer. Here, so I'll slide and do this.
42.
42?
can use that kind of stuff.
Wait, wait, we need to find something else. Twenty. 19 or 20. I'm putting 20.
Here, can we use that? Yeah. You guys can use the bus.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Oh, yes. Always when I get those, like,
wait, wait, wait.
Wait,
wait,
wait.
I want to see.
I never take the whole thing, though. I'm not
ready. No, some people do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, you're evil.
Well, no, I'll take
so there is a What is this? Phelps?
Yeah. Alright, now we need a thing.
Cool story.
Yeah. Let's see if ours stays up to the...
This one's gonna
be
real nice.
Put in that table 5 in your red tray with the binder clips and the washer. Helps make sense of the data. What do you look for? So, Jax, you were. Talking about your data. What were you noticing in your data?
That certain materials that we put the stopper and the washer on, made the stopper and washer fall off at a different angle, at some larger angles than other.
Okay. So some slid at larger angles and some slid at smaller angles. When you start looking at your data like that, what do we call it when you start noticing things like that? It's called
interpreting
your data, okay? And you're using a cross-cutting concept in that, right? Which one? Yeah.
Patterns.
Yeah, patterns, right? So you look for patterns in your data because if you see a pattern, it's predictable. That means there's probably something that's causing it. Right? So what I would like you to look through your data with each other and write down any patterns that you notice. What are some patterns you notice in your data, Seth? Go ahead and talk about it with each other.
The rubber stopper.
And then it was kind of weird because the plastic stopper was only 12 degrees. Maybe we should have done that.
No, you switched them.
I switched them?
Yeah. So, but also the...
So it's 40.
Yeah, it's 40. Yeah, the rougher fabric and the rougher material has caused whatever, either the washer or the stopper, to go down slower and it would take up bigger.
The washer slid down.
It was interesting that the tinfoil was only 1 degree less, whereas all of the other ones had a significant amount of a difference.
Yes.
So maybe it's something in there, or the tinfoil almost left the field in a way.
We are supposed to be doing this.
Oh, I do. Okay, wait.
Thanks for your eyes and for your attention. So, what are some patterns that you guys noticed in your data?
Yeah.
So all of the rougher materials that you put on the bottom always had a steeper angle for both the rubber and the metal compared to, let's say, the plastic or the paper.
Okay, so the rougher materials had a steeper angle for whether it was the rubber stopper or the washer. Do you guys agree with these patterns? Did you find the same patterns?
Yes.
Okay. Do you guys think you could make a model of what was happening? Do you have enough information to make a model of what was happening? Do you guys want to do that for me? For you? So I want you to try to figure out, try to explain what was going on. So really make sense of this information using a model. So do, what I'd like you to do, there are actually two, I want you to do for a rough surface and a smooth surface. What are some things that you need to be sure to have in your model? Shivaji?
Your angle measurements.
Okay. So angle measurements. Sophia, or Roman?
Labels.
What have we been talking about? What was our investigation about?
Friction.